Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my longer Dreamweaver course that's available on bringyourownlaptop.com. But don't worry, there's lots of free stuff here. Check out the description for the exercise file so you can play along with this tutorial. Also in the description, there'll be a link to the playlist that will show you all the stuff that is free as part of this course. All right, let's get on to the tutorial. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do is a desktop, it looks kind of fine. A tablet, needs some work, but it has some real problems down here at mobile. The biggest one is that you can see just there's not enough physical room to fit. It's kind of okay at the 400, but you can see when it gets close to here, they ended up just trying to occupy the same space. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and shrink this logo. So to do it, I'm going to click on the logo. I'm going to go to my sources. Now you will notice that these things just appeared. Okay, they weren't in there before. That is from the font that we added from the Adobe Web Edge fonts. Okay, so we just ignore these for the rest of the class. Fun. Okay, so what I want is in styles.css, and we're going to put it in our mobile. We're going to create a selector, and it's kind of guessed exactly what I want. I want to style this image that is inside an A tag. Okay, the A tag gives it its link to back to the homepage, and inside the header, okay, which is specifically here. If you've got more than one image in this header, it's not going to work. You might have to add a class to it, really specific one, maybe the logo class, and then style that. But because I've only got one image inside the header, this is going to work. Hit return. And what I'm going to say is width. Okay, I'm going to set it to percentage. I'm going to set it to maybe 80. I keep putting double digits in for me. I'm going to complain about that the whole course. Okay, so 83%. 83%. Why is it going to be 83? Double digits. Because I've tested it already. And what that means is that whatever the entire width is, it's only going to be 80% of its original size. So the cool thing about that is you can see when it gets down here, it's going to keep scaling. Now, most mobile phones aren't going to be smaller than about 320. If you do have mobile phones that are smaller than that, it's going to get really small. Am I going to develop a special workaround for them? I'm not. Okay, I'm just going to say that kind of 300 and above it works, and that's most of the cell phones in the world. Next thing to do is we'll do it at tablet first. Is that when I click this, they're not stacking on top of each other. Side by side, you could leave it if you like them side by side, but I want to stack mine on top of each other. So what we do is under styles.css in our tablet, we say probably this item here, desktop view UL ally. We can say, I'd like you to display. Okay, remember we said be inline block, which got it side by side block. We'll just put it on top of each other. And we'll add a bit of padding just so that they don't sit straight on top of each other. Nice. Cool, so that's it done for tablet. What we'll do is we'll, you can see we don't have that class here in the mobile view, so we'll just duplicate it. You can duplicate it, go duplicate into media query, and we'll put it in the mobile one as well. So it's in both of them. Nice. Next thing is the burger menu ends up pushing to the left here. And I played around with floating right and lining right, and it just didn't work. And what I worked out is that these two, okay, are inside this nav. So I've got mobile view and desktop view classes inside this nav, and they can't be inside the same nav. They just can't occupy the same space. So what we need to do is grab the mobile. Okay, we're doing it in code view here. We're just going to grab the mobile div, all this whole line, cut it. Okay, and above nav, I'm going to paste it. Okay, there he is there. I'm going to delete it. A few empty spaces so it lines up. Cool, so it's lost a bit of its styling. It's lost its float right. So what we're going to do is we'll go to styles.css and we'll say under tablet view, we'll make one, there's mobile view, we'll say float to the right, please. Give it a second. Okay, and that made it work. Cool, so buttons pop out. What I might do under mobile view here, I might get all the text to align to the right as well. What I also might do is, I don't know, it's annoying me that these guys aren't aligned on the right. So I want that desktop view. Okay, so in tablet and desktop view, I would like you to align to the right. It looks a bit better. Cool, so I've done tablet view, now we've got to do it for mobile view. So down here, okay, all of those things don't work anymore. So let's do the same things in mobile. So I'd like the mobile view to align right, or actually float to the right. And the desktop view, I'd like you to get the text to align to the right. Nice. All right, so we're getting there, right? One of the last things I might do is that the padding at the top of this is driving me a little mad. So what is it? This thing here, it's the image that's inside my mobile view. So on tablet, okay, do I have something that'll work? Mobile view, that'll probably work. Let's give it a go. And let's just add some margins to the top, drag them out, and it does line up. Now I'm dragging back and forth, about 8 pixels, cool. So down at mobile, I'm probably gonna have to do the same thing. Occasionally the styles flow through the tablet onto the mobile. I'm gonna save all, preview in the browser to make sure that's actually true. So it looks good there, looks good there. Awesome, I'd say we are there and that is a win. That is how we create a jQuery drop-down menu all by our lonesomes. Okay, in the next video, we'll show you how to copy and paste it and do a little bit of cheating, but aren't you proud of yourself? Did you make it work? If you didn't, remember that at the end of every video, I save a version of where I'm at. So depending on where you got stuck, you can look on the screen here somewhere, either in the bottom left or in the comments, there'll be a link to the completed file for that video. Okay, so you can compare yours with this one, just see what might have gone wrong. But if you have done it and you have fixed it and you have got it working, I am very impressed. Because it is very hard. But great thing is, next time you do it, you can copy and paste the code you have made yourself. All right, my friends, let's move on to the next tutorial where we just copy and paste it for the people that are cheating. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, go to Bring Your Own Laptop for the full premium version of this course. Also on that website is a free resources section where you can download PDFs, especially for this, the Dreamweaver cheat sheet. Okay, it's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer, and be more awesome. Bye now.